Hi, Hector Quiroga here with the Quiroga Law Office. Today we're going to be talking about an important subject, and that is the subject of spousal maintenance. Spousal maintenance is, it comes often in dissolution actions or divorce. And the question is often asked, do I owe spousal maintenance, or is that something that we consider in Washington? Now, typically people will ask about alimony, temporary support. There are different words that kind of come go hand in hand when we're talking about spousal maintenance. And they are obviously the same. One party would have to support the, at least temporarily, the lifestyle of the other party, or at least supplement that lifestyle to be back to the point they were used to, and that's the key word. They grew accustomed to a certain lifestyle. Can we subsidize that while the petition is pending, while we have a dissolution finally signed, and maybe sometime after? So that happens. It does happen. It's fully enforceable in Washington, and we seek that, or we defend those type of arguments all the time. Now, the law or the statute that typically comes up in this area is RCW 2609090. Again, that's 2609090, and it's 09090. There's not an O in it. This statute lays out the factors, and I'll put a link down here directly to the Washington State legislature, the revised code of Washington, where you can find that specific language. Now, that RCW will lay out the factors the court has to look at to grant or deny a petition. One, typically, the scenario is one of the parties have substantial income, the other one doesn't, or one of the parties has been the breadwinner for a period of time, and now the other party is being left without the other party's support, and there are bills and expenses and why not that we need to supplement. So the statute goes through A to F list, and in this list it outlines what the court is supposed to look at. So one of the things they're going to look at is the length of the marriage. A longer term marriage will have more of a spousal maintenance type of argument. Then we were going to have a financial party finances. So one of the things we have to submit is a financial declaration. Both sides have to submit this, and the court is going to look at how much money is there available, is there an ability to pay, and whether or not there is an actual need. So that goes back to the finances of both the party seeking the support and the party getting the support. The next thing we're going to look at is the emotional and physical ability of the party who's seeking the support to either be retrained or to actually get employment or continue working. Now, this is a big one because typically parties haven't been working for a while. Typically, mom decides to be a homestay mom. You can also see a stay-at-home dad. And this party has been provided support for. How can this party be retrained and go back to the workforce? Those are the things we're going to be looking at. So all of these elements are going to be put before the court. Now, at the temporary orders stage in Spokane County, we look at, we present this to in a temporary basis to a court commissioner, the court commissioner that has been assigned to the case, and then at trial, this gets presented before the judge. Now, typically, we can get temporary maintenance for a period of time, depending on the marriage, a year, 2 years, 3 years, maybe sometimes 6 months. If it's a long-term marriage, there might be a longer period of time that this may, depending on the party's condition, division of assets, and all of that. However, if you are concerned or you want to talk more about spousal maintenance, the RCW is clear, is RCW 2609090, and that will lay out the factors that the court will look at. Okay, thank you for listening, and until the next time.